Welcome to Puckledge Chevrolet. My name's Phil. I work here at, obviously, Puckledge Chevrolet in Bismarck. Behind me, I've got a 22 Silverado wearing the cherry red, metallic paint, and the Duramax diesel engine. Follow me. I'll show you around this a little bit. You kind of told me that you were looking for something, a new pickup, number one, and something that's going to get a little bit better fuel mileage and have a little bit better torque and all of that stuff. So does that sound about right?
Yes.
Follow me. I'll show you a little bit about this pickup. We'll start with the window sticker over here. So as you can see, it's got a slew of standard equipment, okay? And on all the window stickers of every GM vehicle, it actually itemizes all of that stuff out. So it starts at the top, of course, with a 22 Limited 1500 with the cherry red tank coat and the 3-liter Duramax turbo diesel. Some standard equipment, of course, we're all familiar with this, but I always like to go over it with the customers as a refresher. You get a 3-year, 36,000 mile bumper to bumper warranty. So that covers everything from bumper to bumper. It's going to be paired with a 5-year, 60,000 mile powertrain warranty. But because this is a diesel, you actually get a 5-year, 100,000 mile powertrain warranty. So that's kind of a benefit that you get for it being the new 3-liter diesel. You also get some roadside assistance, some courtesy transportation. That all just comes as standard equipment with the new Silverados and new vehicles. You get a first maintenance visit is covered by General Motors. Here at Puckledge Chevrolet, we'll also cover the next oil change. We'll do a quick inspection on it and get you on the road and back to doing pickup stuff as quick as we can. So just kind of another benefit that we add here at Puckledge Chevrolet. Some standard safety equipment and features: rear vision camera, teen driver mode, tire pressure monitoring with fill alert. That's pretty cool. I'll show you all of this stuff as we go around this pickup, but pretty cool stuff. Some performance and mechanical stuff that comes standard: the auto locking rear differential, of course with the Z71 you get the G80 locker, all that good stuff, and that'll be in the options and pricing. So trailer hitch package, brake pad wear indicator, and then it gets into the connectivity and technology that comes standard. You get the 8-inch touchscreen with the LT, OnStar services, Wi-Fi hotspot. We can connect a bunch of devices to that and keep you connected while you're going down the road and doing your thing. This one is equipped with the Sirius XM radio. Of course, subscription sold separately. You do get a trial period through the OnStar enrollment and all that. We'll go over all that. Okay, your keyless open and remote start, rear seat reminder, all standard equipment on the 22 Limited LTs. So interior standard equipment is going to be a dual zone climate control, 40-20-40 bench cloth seat, a 10-way power seat, leather wrapped steering wheel, carpeted floor, and some rubberized vinyl floor mats. Okay. On the exterior, which I'll go around and show you, standard equipment's gonna be the corner step in the rear, cargo bed rail protectors. You get 12 tie downs in the bed. They all hold about, each corner holds about 500 pounds. I'll show you that when we get to the bed. Some easy lift tailgate, where you can actually lift that with your elbow. I'll show you all that cool stuff. Power adjustable heated mirrors, some LED reflector headlamps, and some daytime running lamps, rear window defrogger, and front recovery hook. So that's standard equipment on an LT. What makes this one special is the options that we put together on this one. So right off the bat, the 3-liter Duramax diesel, and come in a little closer, you can actually see that value there. So the 3-liter diesel is gonna run about $2,300, okay? That's gonna be paired with the diesel off-road package for $2,200. Okay, and that gets you the 373 gear rear end, the DuraTrack tires, the chrome assist steps, trifold hard cover, and then the Z71 package is added on top of that, and that gets us the twin tube shocks, skid plates, hill descent control,
heavier duty air cleaner, the two-speed transfer case, some awesome Z71 badging, dual exhaust polish tips, some 18-inch bright silver painted aluminum wheels, and then we added the safety package. In addition to the standard safety equipment, you're going to get lane change alert with side blowing zone alert, rear cross traffic alert, and then we wrap this in our cherry red tint coat for $495. So they actually, this is a tri-coat paint. They paint it three times. So for $495, that's actually a pretty good value for something that you paint three times, right? Moving on here, a couple of things that's going on right now with the pickups and some of the other vehicles is some of these things, some of the comfort and convenience options are going to be retrofitted. So for instance, this pickup is going to be credited with the heated steering wheel, which will be retrofitted later. Okay, you actually get $25 back on that. Okay, you also get the front heated seats. Those will also be a later retrofit. You get $50 back on that, okay, or $50 off of the price. Okay, and then the front and rear park assist, which I'll show you on the front bumper and the rear bumper. So that's not working, that's in op right now, but that'll also be later retrofitted and will be working hopefully by end of the year, roughly. We're still kind of words out on when that stuff will get fixed, okay? And you get a $50 credit on that as well, all right? So the total price on this is $55,590. So a lot of value added to this vehicle for what it is and the world we live in. So let me show you around this thing, kind of show you what this is. How do these features actually look on the pickup? So sound like something that'd be cool?
Absolutely.
All right, follow me. So we'll start off with the front of this thing, right? So here's our LED headlamps that are fantastic. They're also going to be paired with the LED running light, so that'll stay on all the time. I should have the clicker and I'll show you how that works. And then our turn signal down here. So this headlight pack really commands a presence and makes people notice you as you're coming down the road, and then gives you a good view of the road. So these lights are actually designed to keep the light on the road and in the ditches instead of up and into the eyes of the other, the oncoming drivers and stuff. So that's really an added benefit and a safety feature for you as a driver. So, okay, moving down here. Again, these are our front park assist. These are the ultrasonic sensors. Okay, again, these will be retrofitted for later. So they're not working right now, but they will. And again, no cost to you as the customer. But just so you know, they're there, they're ready to work. We just gotta get the microchip for that stuff, okay? Hang out here, you probably want to see under the hood, right? See what this Duramax diesel is all about. Let me pop the hood, hang on 1 second. All right, so all of the Chevys, they're pretty easy to pop the hood. So aluminum hood, that's gonna keep the weight down really nice and add to the diet that we put the Silverado on to increase a little bit of fuel economy. But the hood's always, you're always looking for the hood latch, right? So quick, easy way, the center line here, center comes right through the hood, down through the awesome bow tie here. It's always palm down and to the left of the center line, stick your hand under there and the latch is right there, okay? So as you notice right there, pretty easy. It's all gas assisted open. So there's no prop rod anymore. You don't have to worry about any of that stuff. Pretty light hood, so we don't have to have a big old gnarly prop rod holding this thing up or anything like that. So here it is. This is the 3-liter Duramax diesel. This is making 277 horse and 460 foot-pounds of torque, okay? So what does that mean to us as the pickup buyer, right? Basically what that does is this gets us the same amount of torque as the big dog, as the 6.2. Everybody talks about the 6.2 power and how it can tow and how it does going down the road. Some common misconceptions that come with the diesel are they're noisy, they rattle, they blow black smoke.
GM's done a fantastic job of eliminating all of that stuff. So because this is an inline six, it's naturally balanced, right? So we don't have to have a whole bunch of counterweights. We don't have to have a whole bunch of other stuff going on internally in the engine to keep it running smooth. You can actually probably set a bottle of water on here while it's running, and it's not gonna, it's just gonna vibrate a little bit. It won't even fall off of there. That'd be a good demonstration for you, right? I should do that. But anyway, paired to a 10-speed transmission, okay, and the 10-speed transmission actually adds to the smoothness of this inline six. And it's got some counterweight balances in the flywheel and some stuff like that that helps in aiding and just making this thing super butter smooth. So some of the other really cool things that set us apart from the competition, number one, and I don't know if you can follow me, if you can see right underneath here, and I'm short, so I got short arms, but right underneath here, right underneath this bonnet right here, that's gonna be our water to air intercooler. Okay, so what does that mean to you as the customer, right? What the heck does that mean? What that means is instead of having a big, in a turbocharged engine, what we need to do is we compress that air, it makes it hot, and hot air doesn't burn as good and make as much power. It's kind of robs some horsepower and torque. So we take the, traditionally, and our competitors will run the hot air from the turbo that's compressed. They run it all the way down through here in a big intercooler. It's called an air-to-air intercooler, and that cools the air before it comes back and goes into the engine. Problem with that is now we've got all of this massive air volume that we have to compress before it gets to the engine and does its work. That's where we have what's called turbo lag. And that's kind of the problem with turbocharged engines, traditionally, is turbo lag. Okay, so a couple of benefits to having a water-to-air intercooler. Number one, it's on top of the engine. It's out of the way in case we get a pheasant, or a, in my case, you hit a cat at 70 miles an hour, and it takes out an intercooler. Now you're off the road, and your engine's in off for a while. And they're expensive, okay? So we move that, GM moved this up out of the way. Any animal strike or anything that happens up here, unfortunately, sometimes that happens, it's not going to get into your intercooler. The other thing that happens, and if you can see, follow me right over here. I know it's really hard to see, but right back here, so that's coming from the turbo and the goes through the intercooler, and then the tube or the air inlet going to the top of the engine is very short. Okay, so that inlet tube is many times smaller than our competitors' intake tubes. So that lessens the turbo lag because we don't have to compress as much air in those big intercoolers. And it doesn't have to go clear down in front, excuse me, of the pickup and do all that stuff. All is contained right up here. All right. Another couple benefits to the inline six compared to our V6 competitors in the Ford and the Dodge. They're running a V6, 3-liter V6. They're making similar power, right? The Dodge makes a little bit more power, but in a V6 configuration, now we have more moving parts, more things to go wrong because you have two heads to contend with instead of one head to contend with, right? So what's that, the benefit to you is, less moving parts means less time in the shop and more added value to you as the customer. Does that make sense? Right on. So anyway, I can go on and on about this diesel engine, but we're gonna have, you know, this is a 29,000 KPI fuel injector, which is fantastic, awesome, making 15-to-1 compression ratio. It's an aluminum block. How the heck do we get that compression out of an aluminum block? Well, the pretty ingenious thing here is they're actually steel sleeves that go inside that create that high pressure. So pretty ingenious stuff by GM, actually, and it all adds to the efficiency, durability, and the added value to the customer. So this thing will get you down the road. You know, one of your big concerns was, you know, fuel economy, and what can I tow with this? So let me show you. Okay. Follow me around here. It's super easy to figure out how the towing on these things. GM provided us with a nice little cheat sheet. So you always ask, what the heck? How much can I tow? What's the curb weight? What's blah, 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 all that good stuff. So they gave us a nice little cheat sheet sticker right here. So it's got your all of your weights here, your curb weights, your max payloads, and then down here is gonna be your conventional trailer weight, okay? Your gooseneck trailer weight, and your max tongue weight. So we're looking at 9,000 pounds on this thing, you can tow, with a conventional trailer hooked up to the bumper. That'd be enough to tow your goodies and your toys and stuff? Yeah, right on, that's what I thought too. It'd be more than enough to tow mine. So any questions that you have on that, it's all spelled out right there on the cheat sheet. So, okay, coming down the side of this thing, this is the Duramax off-road package. So from the side, you'll notice a couple of big things. Number one, the Goodyear DuraTrack tires, okay? A little bit meatier tire, a little bit stronger sidewall, and a nice, nice heavy grip on that. The other cool thing about, if you look inside here, so this is gonna be equipped with DuraLife brake rotors. So what does that mean to you? Again, added value, longevity. They're less apt to get hot because they've got a fancy name for it. I've got it written down somewhere. But anyway, they coat them. Actually, I've got it right here. I had to write this down. It's a ferric nitrocarbonizing on the DuraLife brake rotors. So that just means that it can take some heat. The brake rotors are less apt to warp under heat or anything like that. And just, again, adds in overall value of owning this pickup. So cool, right? So this thing is equipped with running boards and a trifold hard tonneau cover. Okay, that's part of that Duramax off-road package. Now, Puckless Chevrolet has the best GM accessory department in Bismarck, North Dakota. So if your pickup doesn't have this on it, and if we can't get it, you probably don't need it, kind of thing. Wes will probably kill me on that, but anyways. And then if you look on the addendum sticker here, we call it our Pucklage Protection Plan. So we add an all-weather floor liner, okay? Get rid of that so you can kind of see. So these are the GM all-weather floor liners. They're a rubber material, molded, laser cut. So we get that in the front, both sides. And then on the back, I'll show you. We put an all-weather floor liner all the way across the back. So that interlocks and goes underneath the seat. Provides you with a bunch of protection and keeps your investment protected over the long run. Okay, put that back in there. The other thing that we add in addition to those are these molded mud flaps. Again, our GM accessory department here at Puckless Chevrolet is the best in Bismarck. So we put those on right away so the customer doesn't spend nearly as much time at the dealership. It's already ready to go and does some cool stuff. So any other products or anything like that we can talk about to help cover your vehicle, we can go over that in the business department. We've got two or three of the best business managers in the state here. So they do a really, really good job, and I trust them with all of my stuff as well. So any extended service contracts or any sort of products like that that you may need or want, we can get you hooked up with that, okay? So no need to worry about any of that stuff, okay? Coming around the back here, I kind of talked about the tailgate, these pocket steps, and these pocket steps, they made them a little bit bigger, so a nice big boot fits in there. They'll hold about 300 pounds per side. I'm sure that they've underrated those for sure, but I don't know why they didn't do that 30 years ago. That the awesome thing about this step is you can utilize this step, unlike our competitors with the blue oval on the back. They've got a step too, but the only way to access their step is out the end of their tailgate. So if we get to something while the tailgate's closed, we can still use our step with the tailgate up or down. It doesn't matter to us. Okay? So the easy open tailgate, right? The nice thing about this, I wish my parents had this when I was growing up, because kiddos running around that are about this tall, it comes down, it doesn't hit their head and cause brain damage, and then they have to be a car salesman the rest of their life. I'm just kidding. Anyways, so it's kind of a safety thing for the most part, but it also aids in longevity and value of your pickup over the long run. Okay. Again, I mentioned on the window sticker that you can lift this with just your elbow or your hands, right? We're usually always getting stuff out of here, right? And our hands are full. We got bags of groceries. We only make one trip from the car to the house. So then you can just lift this up. It's super easy. It's a nice, easy open tailgate, but you can lift it up with two fingers. Anything that's got a hinge on this pickup, tailgate, doors in the hood, will be aluminum. Everything else on here is steel. Okay, so that's why it's, that partially adds to why it's so easy to open, easy to close. Okay, underneath here, if you can tell, and this is the hard folding tonneau cover, a tri-fold. So it's gonna keep your goodies secure and keep you on the road. It's not gonna flop around like some of the other non-GM accessories. We're gonna have a whole bunch of tie downs on each corner. Each corner will hold up to 500 pounds of tie down force, okay? So three tie downs on each corner. You can kind of see, we got this nice cover on here, so it's probably kind of a little hard to see. I could turn on these awesome LED cargo lights. So these cargo lights have been put in place to shine the LED light on the cargo, and the cargo that you need back here in the back. We don't need the lights up there. We don't need the lights shining down on the cargo up there. We need the lights back here. And GM did an awesome, awesome job of putting these LED cargo lights in the right spots where you need them. Okay? Back here we've got the rear park assist, same as the front park assist. It's just doing it in reverse. Okay, we've got a 4-pin connector for your trailers without trailer brakes. And then underneath here, we have a 7-pin connector for a trailer with trailer brakes, basically. Okay? So it's all plug-and-play stuff. It's ready to rock and roll. All that good stuff is wired up and ready for you. It's been waiting for you. We put dreams in driveways. Step back, you can kind of see the dual exhaust that I mentioned in that Z71 package. Okay, it's gonna give you some styling as you're passing by the competitors with the blue oval on the front grille. They're gonna be envious of that. Any questions so far? We're doing good, right? Coming around here. Like I mentioned, if your driver information display shows that you have a low tire, what you can do, it's actually got a tire fill alert. So if it tells you, hey, the right rear tire's low, you pull up to the gas station or using your little compressor at home or whatever, you just start filling this. And once it gets to the pressure that you want or that it needs, the recommended pressure, the horn will actually honk at you. So pretty awesome, especially when it's 14 below outside. You gotta put some air in and you don't wanna fumble around with a tire gauge. I can't ever find mine anyway. So again, that's gonna be some added benefit to all of that stuff, okay? Move into the inside here. You'll notice our doors open up nice and wide. Get you easy access to kiddos back here, car seats, hunting gear, any of that stuff that you're planning on putting back here. Okay. I'll get in and you can kind of follow me across here.
So these seats do fold up and they stay, they're cantilevered, so they stay. We can fold these headrests down. So in case you need a little more visible room out the rear window, you can see out the back real good. We do have a, so we don't have our own climate control back here, but we do have our own vents back here. So we can kind of control a little bit more of the airflow back here. And then we do have two USBs and a 12 volt back here as well. So connectivity in the back is going to be fantastic. We do have OnStar on board, Wi-Fi, 4G LTE. We can connect 7 devices up to this thing. And you can connect these things a whole bunch of, a long ways away from this vehicle. So I want to say it's 40 feet, but I'll have to check on that. I think it's actually a little further than that now. But anyway, so the all of your passengers can be connected. They can be watching their own, you know, their own shows, searching for, you know, the best fishing spots on the way to the lake while you're pulling the boat, and all that while you're getting, you know, 20 plus miles a gallon out of this thing. So very, very well thought out, very set up, and I think your family will be set for a long time in this thing. So okay, stain resistant seats, a nice tightly woven cloth seat, so you won't have to, you know, maintenance on these seats. Of course, if you spill something, you're still gonna have to clean it up, but it's definitely a lot easier getting these things clean. Okay, I'll follow you out here. Again, everything with the hinge is aluminum, but if you'll notice, compared to our Ford buddies, those things don't close like aluminum doors, they close like steel doors. Okay, no panel vibration, none of that stuff, they open and close really nice. The other thing about the Chevy doors is if you get the door to the first click where it stays, and you push it, they'll close automatically from, or they'll latch all the way closed from that first notch, no matter what. So, kind of cool, right? But we do have a couple of stays. There's 3 different stays there. There's a stay, and then that's the last stay there. So, tight parking lots and stuff like that, your doors are, hopefully your door edges will be maybe a little less apt to get dinged up or something like that. So, okay. Sitting on the inside of this thing, co-pilot seat. Okay, this thing is going to be adjustable. It's not a power seat, but that is available. I can get you a power seat. We'll just have to talk about a couple of different trims there. Hang out here, I'll go around to the other side. So in this front seat, from the co-pilot seat, you got a couple of different glove boxes here. Here's all the goodies. It is lockable, okay? And then we do have another lockable storage underneath here, okay? That is lockable right up here. And then the other cool thing about this is this is a 3-point harness in the middle seat. So that's gonna be something that's been new for this new T-style body, okay? So that's locked up, you get a 3-point harness. So anybody that's sitting up here is gonna be safe and sitting good. Release is right on the driver's side here. Release that down and it comes out, okay? Some more storage here. Keep you organized, keep you rocking and rolling. Some cup holders, keep you going that way. Okay, so if we push the start button and hold it for a count of 10, it's a quick count of 10, right? Kind of lights everything up, that puts us in accessory mode. So again, for the inside features, we do get dual climate control, so you can have a different temperature than your passenger and vice versa. Again, our heated seat buttons that will be fixed will be retrofitted here.
This is a Z71, so we do get a downhill ascent control, traction control, our hazard lights. There's our tailgate deployment button, our auto stop override button, and our parking assist button. Okay. All of our HVAC controls, so we can control the HVAC in any combination that you want, feet, vent, or defrost, wherever you need the air coming out and however fast you need it to come out. It's also equipped with the auto feature, so it'll keep the temperature whatever you have it set at. Okay. Our infotainment system, we got it muted here. Okay, you swipe it a couple of times and now I can access the rear camera without having to put it into reverse. Now it still does come on when we put it in reverse, but as I'm going down the road, I can access this for a couple of seconds. I can check and make sure, you know, I hooked the boat up, made sure that maybe a safety chain's not dragging or something like that. Just some added value there, some added features to keep you on the road and off to your next adventure. Okay. Keeps Felix the cat happy too. Okay, we can go through all of this stuff if you want. We can go through the trailer light test. This is pretty cool. You plug your trailer into it, you start the test, and it starts running your running lights, your brake lights, left turn signal, right turn signal, and your reverse lights. You can do that all by yourself. You don't need somebody else doing that. The pickup will actually do that and then show you all of that stuff, okay? AM, FM, XM radio. We'll go back here. Oh, we better stop it. We'll go back. Your AM, FM, XM radio with Bluetooth capability. Hook your phone up to it, which is very easy. We connect a phone, add a phone, and then just follow the directions. Then you can listen to your favorite podcast, listen to your favorite Fishing Buddies secret spot tips or whatever. Whatever you got going on the podcast there. So, okay. Cancel out of that. Our Wi-Fi hotspot. So we can customize our Wi-Fi. Okay. We can name it, which we will name that once we get the OnStar registered. Okay. You can customize your password. And then it'll show you your devices connected and your hotspot data as well. So we can go over a few things. There's a couple of packages that we can get through the Wi-Fi or through OnStar, I'm sorry, for the OnStar to add Wi-Fi to the pickup and all that good stuff. You can use your My Rewards points. So you'll get a certain amount of rewards points, get about $100 worth of rewards points to use towards anything GM. So you can pay for some Wi-Fi hotspot if you want. You can pay for some OnStar features if you want. You can use that for any service, and you can use that in our GM accessory department as well. So, okay, some pretty cool stuff, right? OnStar is going to be right up here. We do have an SOS button, and you told me you're pretty familiar with OnStar. You're coming from a Chevy pickup, so no worries there. But our SOS button, that's just like dialing 911, except for you don't have to get your phone out. And usually in an emergency situation, you shouldn't be getting your phone out anyway. So that's an added value and feature right there to help maybe help save, you know, your life or somebody else's as well. OnStar Advisor, you push that button and it becomes everything from a concierge service to help on the road to diagnosing maybe a check engine light or anything like that. You can even be gone your way to Fargo and get some tickets to the NDSU football game if you really, really want to. So, and then this is going to just be like our settings button here. So that changes it down to, you can select advisor, turn-by-turn directions, and Wi-Fi hotspot there. You can also check your account. Of course, this is in demo mode, but all of your personal account information will come up there when we register the OnStar. Okay. Steering wheel controls, again, leather wrapped steering wheel, All of your DIC controls or your driver information controls will be accessed right from the right thumb pad. Okay, so that's our home screen there. Okay, that's gonna give us our miles per hour, our distance to empty, and our current mileage, our compass rows, our gear indicator, and our four-wheel drive indicator. We get a little arrow here, and we corresponds with this arrow. And now we can look at some information on the vehicle. So our DEF level, diesel exhaust fluid level, our four-wheel drive, fuel filter life, fuel economy, brake pad life, air filter life. Here's our tire pressures. As long as they're all green, we're in the good. Our oil life monitor. So that's going to be a question that you come that is going to be on your survey that is going to ask if I showed you where your oil life monitor is. How did I help you pair your phone? A few things like that. So I'm going through this thing. Some of this stuff could be just a review for you. But there's a lot of information on this thing for sure. You'll have some questions. You got my phone number. We're texting buddies now, so we'll be good to go there. Okay, cruise control over here. All of our windshield wipers here. Okay, if you can see that, pretty easy. Turn signals, windshield wipers, and our windshield washer. Okay. All of our window controls, mirrors, window locks, door locks. And then on this side, you'll see up here, if you can, this will be the drive mode selector. So we can either select between a normal or an off-road mode. Okay, and then if we turn it counterclockwise, then that turns us into our trailer tow haul mode. So that'll change a little bit of the shifting patterns. And it'll kind of know that you've got a trailer on board and all that good stuff. Okay. Four-wheel drive, push button, four-wheel drive. All of our lights, we can adjust all of our lights and all that good stuff. So in a nutshell, that's kind of the walk around on, our new 22 Limited Silverado with the Duramax diesel. Can I interest you in a test drive?
Let's go.
Right on. Thanks.